everyone. My name is Kiran Mayi, Assistant Professor in EC Department from St. Martin's Engineering College. Today here I am going to explain about the classification of materials. See how the materials are classified into. Materials are classified into three types: conductors, insulators and semiconductors. Conductors means, let us take the example copper. Insulators and third one is semiconductors. For conductors, examples are the copper, aluminium and zinc. If you use the copper, is the best example for conductivity. Conductivity means by applying an electric field, the flow of current electrons will be taking place. See, if you have a circuit in between, in front of you, to connect those circuit, we have to use a connecting wires. In that connecting wires, they use the material. It is a copper. Okay, that is the metal which we are using in these connecting wires are copper. Copper is the best. It is having the best property of conductivity. For connecting different types of components as a circuit, we are going to use the copper as a connection, copper in the connecting wire, right? If I have a battery, I want to connect it to the bulb. For that purpose, if I take the rope and connect to the bulb, it does not conduct, right? So for connecting the battery to the bulb, we get the the flow of electricity will be taking place through the connecting wire. So we are using the copper as a conductor, which is having the high conductivity property and the low power loss will be available. The power loss will be very less in this if you use the copper as a conductor. And also, in the previous days, they used aluminium as a fans, they are using aluminium. In that case, there will be a more power loss will be available. In conductors, before going to the conductors, let us see. Let us take a nature having different types of atoms. Let us suppose take a sodium which is having an atomic number of 11. To get how this is acting as a conductor, let us see. In the previous cases, for this atomic number, sodium is acting as a gas, which is the atoms are loosely bound in the gas. So the sodium atomic number is 11. Let us write the electronic configuration for this sodium. This is 1s2. 2s2, 2p6, here it is 4, so 3s. So this we can take as the, here it is having quantum levels, quantum states we can say. Quantum states means, here it is 3s1, sorry. Quantum states, this is 1s, we can write. For 1s, it is 2, it is 1s, so 2 number of quantum states. And here it is 2s, second one. Here it is having 2s2, 2 number. 3s, here it is 3p. See, here it is having 2 number, and 2p, 2p is 6 number here. Here 3s1. So, here for this second orbit to the third state, here having only one electron, means here it is a free electron. Let us talking about the free electron. If there is a free electron in the outermost shell, in that case it is free, right? If we give an externally thermal energy, if we apply a thermal energy to an atom, then this free electron tries to jump into the another atom. Let us suppose take in the nature, it is having a nucleus. Around this nucleus, the shells. Here it having 1s, 2s, quantum states 2p and 3s. In this third, here it is having one free electron, right? This is free now. So this has a freedom of moving into the nature of having the same atomic number. In this sodium, we can sodium we can use in a street lights, means the gas. So sodium is a gas. It is a gaseous state. So the atoms are loosely bound. If it is loosely bound, they cannot able to bond with the another atom in the same gaseous state. So in that case, another nucleus here having 1s, 2s, 2p and 3s. In this 3s, it may be here, and the free electron may be here. So this may, when we apply an external source, when we apply a thermal energy, at that case this free electron may enter in, may try to bond with the another atom in the same state. So this may come into this state, or this may enter into another state, or this may enter into the this state. This happens. So in that case, here it is a free electron gives the main responsibility or main intention how the conductivity taking place. Let us see here. This is free electron. We are seeing this free electron. Whatever the free electron available band, we are calling it as conduction band. Mainly, conductor means the overlapping of conduction band and valence band takes place. Means the energy gap between the valence band and conduction band is zero. In that case, the conductivity takes place. Means we can say that type of material is known as a conductor. Now, this the free electron, whatever the free or empty state, we can say this band is a conduction band. Whatever the below this conduction band, that is fully bonded, then that band we are calling it as a valence band. Okay, understood? This conduction band and valence band, when we give an externally when we apply an external source or apply a thermal energy, in that case this electrons, free electrons will bond, and this conduction band and valence band may get overlap, then the conductivity process will be running. Next, if this explains the sodium gas. The sodium, it is of gaseous state, so the electrons may jump. It is loosely bound. If we get into the lattice, means solid, when it enter into the solid state, it is comes nearer. Means the atoms in the solid state are nearer. It forms in a lattice, right? In that case, the flow of electrons will, when we apply some energy also, it will flow from one atom to the another atom in that case. So the conduction will be possible here. Now see, if we take magnesium having atomic number is equals to 12. Here in this for this magnesium, electronic configuration is 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2. Here it is. So it is fully bonded, right? When we take quantum states 1s, 2s, the energy band, the gap which you are observing, see, the gap which you are observing from one state to the other state is known as energy gap. This determines the conduction and this determines the material property. See, 1s, 2s here, 3s, sorry, 2p, 3s. So this is completely filled, means this is overlapping. Here we cannot say this magnesium is a non-conductor. This is also a conductor, but in the same cell it is fully bonded. Here it is a 3p is free state, right? So in this third orbit 3p is free. So this 3p is overlapping with this 3s state. Okay, this is also a good conductor. The gap between 1s and this one and second orbit, this gap we are calling it as an energy gap. And also here, from this 2s to 2p, this is also an energy gap. Conductors means the energy gap is very less. Now let us see conduction process or conductors. When we give externally thermal energy or electric field, the flow of electrons takes place and bonded with the another atom in the same state. Now let us see insulator. What does the insulator mean? Insulator example will be paper, wood, glass. These are insulators. Means insulators does not conduct. If we give an electric field also, it won't conduct. Let us take wood. The main example. If we take why we will use wood for connecting switchboards and everything. Plastic also we can. If we apply an external, if we apply an electric field, does the plastic will conduct? No, right? So these materials won't conduct. The materials would not connect it to the electric field. We can say it as a insulators. Before going to the semiconductors, semiconductors means partially conducting. Semiconductors means partially conducting. Let us take for the semiconductor examples are silicon and germanium. These are having the energy gap of 1 electron volt silicon, 0.7 electron volt germanium. See, silicon. What is the atomic number for silicon here? 14. Is equal to 14. In the periodic table, for above the silicon, there will be carbon. Carbon having an atomic number 6, so it is 1s2, 2s2, and 2p2. Here it is 4 are empty, right? So in carbon, the space or the space between the conduction band and valence band is. Means we can say the space between conduction and valence band is energy gap, right? Energy gap is 6 electron volt. Means this is more, this gap is very, very high. So if we give an external source also, it won't conduct. Means there is no flow of electrons from one state to the another state. So this carbon is non-conductor here. So let us see here silicon having the atomic number 14. For the electronic configuration, it is 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, and here it is 12, and 3p2. See, in most of the cases, for silicon, these states 1s, 2s, 2p, 3s, 3p. Energy gap. Here it is having two number. Here it is having two number. Here it is six number. Six are filled. Two are filled. Here also two are filled. Here 3s in this two also filled. Here it is 3p2, right? So it should obtain six number. So there are four are remaining, right? Four are free electrons here. Okay. These are four free electrons. So, in case we can write this as sp3 also. Means here 8 quantum states are there. Means 3s, here it is 3s and 3p2. Here 8 quantum states are available here. In that, only 4 are filled, 4 is remaining, right? These are the four remaining quantum states. These needs to bond with the another atom in the same solid state, we can say. Means in semiconductor, for the silicon, the energy gap is 1 electron volt. 1 electron volt is equals to 1.6 into 10 to the power of minus 19 joules per second. Right. See, we can in semiconductors are classified into two types. Okay, these are classified into two types. One, first one is intrinsic semiconductor, extrinsic semiconductor. Let us see about these intrinsic and extrinsic semiconductors in the next video. Thank you.